Barriers and making history. From theater to music, Grammy award-winning artist Jamecia Bennett is one of the first black women to be a resident artist at the Ordway. We visited her there to get an up-close look. You know, when you walk into this place, did you ever think that there would be a day where this would be a home base for you at the Ordway?
I knew the moment I walked in here.
People don't understand how much music just completely runs through your veins. How long have you been singing?
I've been singing since I was 4 years old. Yes, absolutely. And all the way to now, singing is definitely in my veins because of my family. It's a lineage of us for singing, absolutely.
And it's taken you so many places. Let's talk about some of those stops that you've made along the way.
I was signed with Jimmy Jam and Terry Lewis. I got signed with them when I was only 17. I was the youngest person in the Sounds of Blackness. Ended up doing that. Of course, we did Optimistic. We had all of these major hits and doing that. And then I had the opportunity to be signed with Mercury Records and A&M. And that led to so many other things as well. I had a platinum album for Rodeo Style on the Jason's Lyric soundtrack. I was able to do the Kazam soundtrack, Shaquille O'Neal's song, on the Mo Money soundtrack. And then coming back and forth, working with Jimmy and Terry, I was able to do 3 Janet albums, Rod Stewart, did Sting, Patti LaBelle, you name it. I had an opportunity, Luther, I had so many opportunities to work with a plethora of artists. And then from that point, continuing the baton passing from my mother, and now I'm the new lead singer, featured lead singer for the Sounds of Blackness. Spread your wings and
fly. You know, tell me the parts of this show that you really think people will connect with.
The moments that people will connect with this show would probably be just getting the history of music and knowing the roots, that this is the absolute root music from which all music came from. It comes from African roots to jazz to blues and of course soul. You have all these elements of roots.
What does opening doors look like for you? Because it sounds like from your journey, opening doors not just for your music but for others who are inspired by your story, by your music, seems just as important to you.
Yes, very much so. Opening doors is the reason why I started Minnesota Movement, my company. It's an artist development company where I mentor young people and put them on stage with me. And I always felt like, what better way to have the experience of working like this, but with a person with accolades. And I'm blessed to be able to say that humbly, and to work with these young people and open the doors. This is one of these opportunities on February 23rd for me to do this. And if I can do this, having all these young people that, you know, that are gonna come and see me, knowing that a place like Ordway is offering this opportunity. I just want to personally thank the Twin Cities for always supporting me in whatever I do, from the restaurant, from Pimento, to my music career, to my family. It's just been a blessing to be able to grow up in a place of music. It has definitely fueled me to continue to be the example that other young people need when it comes to the music industry.